feels good to win. You know what I mean? Just feels really good to win. A lot of good things happened out there, you know, in a lot of different phases. Just happy for our guys, happy to get a W. We needed that badly, and just happy for our players.
Questions?
And they got to within 14-7 to get that safety, and then you had three touchdowns after that. And just had to talk about that sequence and just change momentum at that point.
Just felt like, you know, just the same old things. We take care of the ball, you know what I mean, just that we'd be okay. Just proud of the way our guys bounced back. You know, well, actually, I'm not really sure how many offensive plays we had, but, you know, didn't have the ball too much. But it's a good win. You know, Parrish's pick was huge. You know, a lot of big plays that happened. You know, we shot ourselves in the foot a little bit early in the game with some penalties and the turnover. But to our kids' credit, they continued to battle.
Encouraging to be able to get some sacks and then create some turnovers, especially going into the bye week, to have some confidence there.
Well, just it's good to win because, you know, we recognize, you know, we, you know, had some tough games to start the season. And just to be able to get a win, to get a lot of guys in the game that haven't played, I thought it was good for the morale of our team. You know, we got this. We got a week off with this bye week. So, you know, just try to get healthy. You know, those beginning part of season, like I said, there was some physical battles. Our guys were starting to, you know, wear down a little bit. So, this bye comes at a good time, and you know, we'll try to get healthy and get ready for San Jose State.
What did you think of Tonga's play, quarterback?
I thought he played well. I thought he played really well. Did a lot of good things. You know, the turnover wasn't his fault. You know, we turned the guy loose at the point of attack, and so it wasn't his fault. I thought he made some good throws. You know, he's played two football games for us, and he's played really well. So, you know, it's encouraging to have two good quarterbacks. Obviously, Keenan's still our starter. You know what I mean? So it was good for Keenan to get some rest, you know, get healthy next week. You know, and Keenan will be back for San Jose State, but... You know, it's nice, you know, your starter's down and your backup comes in and does a really good job. So I was proud of the way Tonga played.
You were able to get a couple sacks today after just one over the first half of the season. Can you talk a little about the defense and maybe getting some pressure on the quarterback?
You know, a little bit more aggressive, you know, it was a big emphasis. And, you know, the guys did a good job, you know, trying to get off blocks and, you know, putting pressure on the quarterback. And, you know, Buddy dialed up some good things on defense. And, you know, the guys were able to execute, but... You know, all those things we needed. You know, we pick for a touchdown. You know, we were getting them off the field early on defense. You know, and so I thought we did some good things and getting some pressure and rallying to the ball. Just guys played well today.
The fullbacks, once again, another big day in total between Swain, Copeland, and Singleton. I think they had over 200 yards and Noah over 100. Can you just talk about how well the fullback group has been playing for you all season?
Well, they're playing well, and normally if the fullback's playing well, that means the O-line's playing well. You know what I mean? It just and so we're just able to get some good blocks inside. And from Noah to Chris, you know, Quentin came in there. Both Quentins came in there and did a good job. But, you know, we're a triple-option team. You know, first and foremost, starts with the fullback. And, you know, really pleased with the way those guys have played. But we got to continue to do that. You know, we got to continue to get the fullback going. You know, if that's where everything starts. You know, we're an inside-out team. Force people to take away the fullback and go to the quarterback and pitch after that.
And you had to shuffle the offensive line coming in and Gaston gets hurt. First of all, is he okay? And then where do you see that group going forward?
I think Gaston will be back. You know, I mean, just the hamstring deal. Hopefully he'll be back. Hopefully Tanner will be coming back. We'll kind of see where Blaze is at. But like I said, I mean... those guys inside, you can't hide at offensive line. I mean, and we're mismatched every week, just like we are on D-line. I mean, we go against guys that are bigger than us every week, and so it started to take its toll on our players, but we got some tough kids, man. These are some tough kids. They don't flinch. You know, guys that they play are 40, 50 pounds heavier than them, you know, 4 inches taller than them, but they don't flinch. We got some tough kids up front.
You got over a quarter of reserves in the game on both sides of the ball. Is it good to get some film on these guys in a real game to see what they can do, whether they execute their assignments, et cetera?
I think we pretty much got we try to get everybody on our team on the field. Whether it is on special teams, you know, we try to get as many guys as we could on the field. But it's good for your morale, you know, especially You know, as we know, the beginning part of the season hasn't been going the way we wanted. You know, just to get guys on the field, it's good for your morale going into the off week. And, you know, we got to get healthy. You know, guys got to get caught up with their schoolwork. You know, it's a good week for us to kind of, you know, get your bearings a little bit. Because the pace of the academy life is grueling. And so, you know, to kind of catch up with all that stuff will help them. Keenan can get some rest, so it's good for him, you know. So there are a lot of good things that I'm excited about as we come back. That's all I had on that, too.
I may have come in a little late, so maybe if I ask the question differently, what do you take away from a win like this after what you've gone through the last 3 weeks to have a, you know, a feel-good win like this one?
A win is a win, and the wins are hard to come by. And, you know what I mean, just you take any way you can get it, you know what I mean, just – because it's like I told our team coming in right now, you know, going to this game, we're 2-4, but we know we could very easily be 6-0. I mean, that's the reality. You know, I mean, it wasn't like people were blowing us out. You know, 2012, we go to Ireland and get smashed by, you know, Notre Dame and get smashed by Penn State. This year was totally different. You know, I mean, we weren't making enough plays. We just need to keep going. You know, it's kind of like sometimes in golf, you know, analogies, sometimes a golfer, you know, misses some putts and he starts getting 18 different coaches and starts getting a new putter. Or if you're a three-point shooter and you miss some shots and you start, you know, going to Europe to find a shooting guru, we just had to keep playing. You know what I mean? And just I'll let you guys write about what we need to do to get better, but we knew we just had to go back to work and just keep playing. The game's not a complicated game. We've got to hang out to the ball. We've got to tackle the guy at the ball. And we weren't doing it. You know what I mean? And so I'm encouraged because a win is a win. And it was a great win for our team, and we needed it badly going into this off week.
I know you just kind of talk a little about getting back on the winning track, and obviously you had a big contribution, 107 yards, a couple of touchdowns there.
Right. It was big for us. We got to just continue to put those under our belt, continue to just grind, and we got to go back to work on Tuesday. So it doesn't matter that we win. I mean, we got to celebrate, but then we got to come back to work.
Parrish interception for a touchdown as part of it. After that safety, you kind of scored three in a row and kind of pulled away. Just, can you talk about that sequence and how important the interception was?
Just one thing I saw out there today, you know, we're just having fun. Something I think we've been lacking a little bit. So we're going to take this and we're going to run with it. And as far as for those sequence of events, I just think we were dialed in today in this game to play.
Tago, how did you feel like you played today?
It's all right. I always feel like you can do better. Always the hardest critic on yourself. So, I mean, at the same time, happy with the victory. At the same time, still always things you can improve on.
Tago, for just getting a win going into a bye week and then able to get some more rest, is there maybe a little more confidence than it has been in the past couple weeks now?
I would say so. Only because at the same time, we got to go into this bye week, get a little rest, and at the same time, get rested up, get back healthy for the next week.
You know, another big day for the fullbacks as a group, but is there anything in particular that's happening that is enabling you guys to have such big games?
No, we're just reading our keys, listening to Coach Judge, trusting our eyes, playing fast, and just competing with each other and just having fun.
Parrish, what can a win like this do for you going into a bye week and then for the starting second half of the season on a positive note?
I mean, it's everything for us. I mean, you know, we pride ourselves on getting wins and getting wins the right way, you know, by not turning over the ball and by getting three and outs and turnovers. So I think, you know, this will definitely catapult us for the rest of the season. And we got San Jose coming in here, and, you know, they gave us trouble in the past. So I think a win going into that game will definitely help us out, increase morale, and, you know, with the long week of practice this week and next week, I think we'll be ready to go.
You know, the coach thought it was a good time for a bye. Do you sense that, you know, this far into the season, bumps and bruises, et cetera, whatever's going on with school, with the academy, is this a good time for a break?
Right, you know, it's good. It's good to get a break. You know, school's kind of wrapping up a little bit. You know, some key players are hurt. You know, we need them to get healthy. And it's just good to be able to rest and, you know, get healthy and just perfect the craft in the bye week and then come out next week and play San Jose State.
Questions for players? All right, thanks.